Hi, I'm Artifacts. I don't know how many of you out there remember who the Lone Ranger is. But the Lone Ranger movie just demonstrated concisely why it is that Hollywood is going right down the tubes. The films keep losing money. Question is why? Well, it's easy to see. I'm going to use the Lone Ranger movie as an example of why. Maybe you will get it, Mr. Hollywood producer. Maybe you won't. I don't know. But we're going to try. Okay. You know, I recently saw something on the front of a magazine. And initially, I didn't read the captions to the left. I saw this picture of this, I'm just going to say creature. I couldn't even identify it. I didn't know whether this was supposed to be about a sci-fi movie or horror movie or what it was. I knew it was a human actor, that's all I knew. But I could not identify what I was seeing. It wasn't until after I read the caption that I knew what I was seeing. It was Johnny Depp as Tonto. I almost gasped. Johnny Depp as Tonto? It's nothing against Johnny Depp. But this did not in any way, shape, matter, or form look like an Indian. I'm going, what's up with this? Well, I found out what was up, what the problem with the movie was. I learned about it from talk radio. And here's the deal. This Lone Ranger is made up by Hollywood. Hollyweird, as I call him. This Lone Ranger, it turns out, is hiding behind a mask. And the reason he's hiding behind a mask is that he assisted in the massacre of, I don't know how many Indians, some Indian village, and he's hiding behind his mask because if anybody finds out who he is, they're going to string him up. That's a very serious mistake. On top of the fact that Tonto didn't look like anything like Tonto. If I remember Tonto right, the original one wore like leathers and maybe a feather or two. I haven't seen those serials in a long time, so I can't remember 100%. But this is the same mistake that Hollywood makes over and over and over and over again. You'd think they would learn, but they don't. Let me give you a little clue. You don't make your heroes into villains. Lone Ranger, the original concept of this Lone Ranger was of this mysterious masked good guy went around with his sidekick, Tonto, and together they fought against evil and corruption and all this. Good versus bad. Anybody who knows about those Saturday morning serials from a long way back knows that was the theme, good versus bad. It didn't matter whether you were in the Old West or you were in the kingdom of Mongol, like Flash Gordon was, fighting Ming the Merciless. It didn't matter. They were fighting, it was good versus evil. Now, we have a complication in that the evangelical Christians nowadays are saying there's none good, based on something that Christ supposedly said, there is none good but the Father, and we're all sinners, and little old lady with two cats never harmed anybody in her life and raised five children, if she doesn't say a sinner's prayer, she's going to burn in hell just like a drug dealer. I'm not buying that. I'm very sorry. I think that's a load of horse pucky. I can't see any god condemning some little old lady like that, or, you know, the honest cop who fought against crime all his life, or You name it. There's good versus evil. And this leads me up to what I was going to say to Hollyweird. Let's look at a movie that was unbelievably popular. Star Wars, the original one. Why was that popular? Well, I believe it's because it was a clear-cut case of good versus evil. You have the farm boy, Luke Skywalker, after his uncle and aunt are murdered by the evil empire, he decides to join the rebellion against the bad guys. You have the smuggler. Han Solo. Even he eventually turns away from his smuggling for the bad guy, Jabba the Hutt. Turns into a good guy fighting for the resistance. Basically, it's good versus evil. Even though some of them started out as not such good people, they at least see the light and turn to good, fighting the evil emperor. That's why it was so popular, I believe. And of course, you have Princess Leia. She's on the side of good. She's one of the good people. She personifies good and all that's holy and all that. See, that made a successful movie. Because I believe that people want to see the good guys and don't want to see the bad guys being portrayed as the protagonists. Now let's look at the garbage that Hollywood's putting out. A pretty woman, a prostitute, is the main character. A prostitute. Not some moral woman, raising three kids and maybe fighting against injustice or something. A prostitute. And then you have drug dealers and pimps and bank robbers. Those have become the main characters. They've become the heroes. There's your problem right there. I think that most people want to see good guys fighting bad guys. Good versus evil. I'll give you another example. From 1953, War of the Worlds. I don't want to get too much into the politics of the original War of the Worlds. It's more complicated than 1953 movie was. H.G. Wells was making some sort of a statement about excessive military power, and if you're familiar with the genre, he also alluded to Brave New World by Aldous Huxley and a couple other things. At any rate, 1953 movie showed people fighting bravely against the evil invading Martians, and they were good people. They weren't bad people. Then you go to the remake, and the remake, the people weren't really bad, but they weren't the heroic type of people, the moral, the good people that there was in the original. I'm a bit of a hypocrite. I actually liked the remake just about as much. Well, not quite as much as the original, but I thought it was okay. I'm a sci-fi buff, so sue me. Anyway, there's your trouble right there. You go and put the drug dealer, the pimp, the hooker, the bank robber, the crime boss. Those are the good guys nowadays, and the cops are the bad guys. Well, I believe that most people don't want to see that crap. They want to see a real Lone Ranger. The mysterious guy behind the mask with a white hat. going around the Wild West and doing good and fighting against evil. We don't want to hear that he massacred 5,000 Indians or whatever. That's baloney. There's your trouble. That's why your movies keep tanking, Mr. Hollyweird producer. There's your trouble in a nutshell. Stop portraying the good guys as bad guys and the bad guys as good guys. And I actually can say the exact same thing for the evangelical Christians, to some extent, except they portray everybody as bad guys. I'm not into that. I have so many intellectual objections to the idea some little granny is going to burn in hell if she doesn't say a sinner's prayer. I have very serious intellectual objections to that. I don't think it's right. I'm sorry. You can spot all the Bible verses you want. It's not going to cut the soap with me. So my suggestion to you Hollyweird producers is...